to CLIPS, Conversations Leading to Insights on Policy and Science. My name is Dr. Natasha Williams, the Legislative Liaison at the National Institute on Minority Health and Health Disparities. Today, our guest speaker is Dr. Pérez-Stable, the Director of NIMHD. He will outline the mission, vision, and research strategies for the Institute. Thank you for joining us. We hope you enjoy the presentation.
Hello, my name is Eliseo Pérez-Stable, and I'm the Director of the National Institute of Minority Health and Health Disparities. I came to Bethesda in September 2015 after spending 32 years on the faculty at the University of California, San Francisco. There, I was a general internist, primary care physician, and at the last 15 years, chief of the Division of General Internal Medicine in the Department of Medicine. My passion in research has been focused on addressing healthcare disparities among minority populations, especially Latino populations, around tobacco prevention, cessation, cancer screening, and cancer detection. Today, I will present to you my vision and agenda for the NIMHD over the next 5 years. As a background history, this institute was established under the director of the Department of Health and Human Services, Secretary Louis Sullivan, in 1990 as an office in the Office of the Director of NIH. In 1999-2000, it was transitioned to a center through legislation championed by Representative Louis Stokes. The Patient Protection and Affordable Care Act in 2010 included language that was championed by Senator Cardin to transition to an institute. And Dr. John Ruffin had been the leader and director of all of these entities until he retired in March 2014. Dr. Yvonne Maddox was acting director in the interval until I started in September. Our budget in fiscal 2016 was approximately $280 million. NIMHD's mission is to lead scientific research that advances our understanding of minority health and health disparities. We really support research in minority health that focuses within groups defined by racial ethnic groups in the U.S. Census. We also support research to understand causes of and how to reduce health disparities in different populations. We're very committed to diversifying the scientific workforce across the United States, and we'll support that as a broad NIH mandate. And we're also interested in translating and disseminating research information about minority health and health disparities to the general public. My goal is to continue to foster collaborations both within NIH and across the federal government, as well with our extramural investigator community. It's important to clarify the definition of this terminology because there has been much confusion in the past. Minority health and health disparities are often treated as synonyms, and they do overlap in their interest, but have some variance that is not mutually shared. All differences are not necessarily health disparities, and in some cases, minority groups have better health outcomes, which is also important to understand. Inclusion of minorities in clinical trials, clinical studies of all kinds, is a separate domain and not part of minority health. This is an issue of common sense and social justice, and we need to distinguish that from the mandate of minority health and health disparities. In defining minority health, we look at distinctive characteristics and attributes of the principal minority racial ethnic groups in the U.S., as defined by the U.S. Census. All of these groups share a certain amount of social disadvantage and being subject to some form of discrimination during their historical time in the United States, with some worse than others. All of these groups are historically underrepresented in biomedical research, and most are also underrepresented in the scientific workforce. These are the minority health populations as classified by Office of Management and Budget Standards in the classification of race ethnic groups in the U.S. There are African Americans or blacks, Asian Americans that represent over 30 countries and just as many or more languages, American Indian or Alaska Native, Native Hawaiian or other Pacific Islanders, and these are distinguished from Asian Americans, and Latino or Hispanics, which again represent over 20 countries and are a heterogeneous racially ethnic group. So differences in outcomes or events is what we're looking at in terms of health disparities. And this is a proposed classification that we are working on. So we're all interested in incidence of disease and prevalence, and so easily diagnosed diseases and that we list in many registries as morbidity with specific diagnosis such as cardiovascular disease or cancer, stroke, etc. Everyone is also wants to know how long you survive. So poor survival outcomes, ultimate outcome of mortality is included. All of the measures that we use to evaluate how people feel, how patients feel in terms of quality of life, symptoms, and function are important, and these must be done with standardized measures that are validated and reliable. Use of health services is a fourth category. So hospitalization rates, which we all want to reduce unless it's necessary, emergency room or emergency department visits, use of appropriate or inappropriate use of health services in terms of tests ordered or visits. A fifth category are incident events that are hard to classify with a diagnosis, such as falls, transition from one stage of disease to another that leads to more intensive therapy. And finally, a common metric used in population health, such as disability-adjusted life years, that have been used widely by the World Health Organization and other public health agencies. Health disparities, then, is defined as a health difference that adversely affects a disadvantaged population based on one of these health outcomes that I outlined earlier. This health disparities research is really devoted to understanding this, how these things occur, both in terms of advancing knowledge of health determinants and defining mechanisms of how these outcomes end up being different. Eventually, we want to translate this knowledge and understanding of mechanisms into interventions that can be tested to see whether they can reduce and ultimately eliminate health disparities and lead to greater health equity. Health disparity populations have been defined as follows. All of the minority racial ethnic groups included in the Office of Management Budget Standards. Poor individuals, low income, less education, low wealth, less privileged social class, however one defines this. And a rural geographic location has also been included by the NIH. Our sister federal agency, the Agency for Healthcare Research and Quality, has been mandated to include priority populations, and we're often compared to this. Their list of priority populations includes most of the rest of the population, as you can see. A particular interest to us are sexual and gender minorities, immigrants, and chronically ill individuals with special needs, such as those at the end of life with multiple chronic disorders, or the very elderly, or the very young. Minority health and health disparities, activities and strategies really is focused on understanding the etiology of adverse health outcomes associated with race, ethnicity, and socioeconomic status. We're also interested in knowing why some groups will have better health outcomes within a certain racial ethnic group despite having adverse socioeconomic status. Defining these mechanisms include understanding social, behavioral, environmental, biological, and clinical factors that determine these health disparity outcomes. Then developing and testing interventions to improve health status on these target conditions and establish the science of health disparities. Our institute needs to set the standards for methods, for metrics and tools to understand mechanisms of health disparities. We're also going to be supportive of tracking trends, monitoring by these metrics and inclusion of minority populations in biobanks, registries, and clinical trials. Some questions that will be relevant for us to address in health disparities research follow. How do differences in risk factors translate to health disparities? And this varies by certain groups.
What social determinants interact with the behavior, environment, and biology that results in a health disparity? In other words, what are the mechanisms? Why are there more aggressive biological forms of disease that exist in some populations and not others? How and where does one intervene? What button do we need to push to make things better? And what defines better health outcomes among traditionally disadvantaged groups? Now, health determinants, thinking about all these determinants of factors under these different large categories, helps us define a strategy for the science of health disparities as a multidisciplinary approach across the lifespan that examines all these different health determinants in influencing outcomes that lead to health disparities. These mechanisms include, for example, earlier age of onset, maybe a consequence of adverse childhood experiences. Faster progression of disease. We think much of this relates to genetics or biology, but may also be related to interactions with environment and first adverse social conditions that lead to changes and faster progression. Later diagnosis, often due to access, lack of health insurance, lack of access to clinical services. They also lead to individual barriers and poor adherence or resistance to seek consultation for their symptoms. And finally, differential treatment results, which may be response differences based on issues of pharmacogenetics, for example, or adherence or other physiological factors and so interacting with social factors that are not yet fully described. This complicated slide is a framework that our scientific staff at NIMHD have developed to help us understand how these things interact. And it displays for us both the complexity of what leads to health disparities, but also allows individual researchers to see where on this framework their work fits. Is it on the biology, on the behavior, on the physical or social cultural environment, or within the healthcare system, or across all of these? How it affects both the individual, the family unit, the interpersonal, social aspects of individuals, the community at large, or the larger society in terms of policy or other aspects of access and care. And this allows us to then to consider the entire landscape of how you define health disparities for our populations. NIMHD will have a priority really to define and promote the science of health disparities and minority health. This is our number one priority. We want to promote innovation from our extramural scientists in population sciences. We need you to apply for more grants that come to NIMHD. We also want to establish a strong health services research in the clinical setting program, and this will be a priority that we will promote. I want to stimulate innovation, have investigator-initiated research come through our program, our institute, and not necessarily go first to the other institutes. And we also will be explicit as much as we can in promoting diversity in the workforce. Thank you for your attention.